When you memorize a 70-minute speech, do you forget bits? Did you yesterday?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, it's not really about memorizing the speech. Look, what I try and do is I try and write a speech, and then I use it as the basis for what I want to say to the country. And look, you know, in a way, I could just stand there and read out a speech that's been prepared earlier. I like it as a way of engaging with people. And of course, it's one of the perils of it is that there are bits that get left out, bits that get added in. So it sort of comes with the territory, but look, I find it quite an effective way of communicating with people. Others will have to be the judge of that.
I think people are still confused, though, how, as you know, somebody who's bidding to be prime minister could leave out the one subject, the economy and the deficit, which most people need to know about. And you know, you've held your hands up and said, yeah, you know, it was a speech and I didn't remember all of it. How could you not remember to talk about the economy?
Well, the speech was all about the economy, actually, Susanna. It's really important to say this.
Address the deficit during your speech.
The speech was all about how we change our economy so it works for working people again. You see, I think the big choice at this election is whether we carry on with an economy that just serves a few people at the top, or we change that economy. Raising the minimum wage to £8 an hour, having apprenticeships for people so that as many of our young people, a 10-year goal, that as many of our young people leave school or college to go to an apprenticeship as currently go to university, building homes again, all of those are economic issues. Now, I think the fundamental issue we face in Britain is that while we've got a government that says the economy is fixed, it actually doesn't work for most people. So I think that is the big choice at the election, and that's what I laid out yesterday.